Coin Toss, and it's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. The pregame festivities are over, and we're just about set to get this game underway. He's out to the 30. Down the sideline. He returns it all the way to score. And he tacks on the extra point. They line up to kick this one away. Brought down at the 32-yard line. The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game.
Players in the college game that can make something happen when the blocking breaks down. But when it's that bad, I don't care who you are, you're going down for a loss.
Second down and 14. Ball on their own 28. Makes the grab and steps out right away. Superb effort by the receiver to come down with that ball.
This comes down to the timing between the quarterback and the receiver, and the result, again, a nice play for the offense.
From their own 49-yard line, first down. They'll go ground. Nice run there as they work the outside. Play fake, looking to run. And he's taken down at the 34-yard line.
This is a nice run for the first down by this quarterback.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 34.
That's not what you hope for from your running game. You're looking for some solid north and south progress. You never want to give the defense a play like that to build their confidence.
Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. Throws quick to the receiver and it falls incomplete. Change of quarterback, Kirby. You've got to wonder what that's going to do to the team morale. It is next man up. They've got to be ready to trust this guy. Third down, and they need to get it to the 24. Fires back to the tailback, but he can't bring it in. And they could really put their opponent in bad field position with a good punt here. And this one is a beauty. And it goes out of the end zone for the touchback. So you wonder what kind of excitement we'll see this time around. At about the 33-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 33. Scrambling around. And he's going to be sacked for a loss. He just blew past the blockers and dragged the quarterback down.
Boy, excellent play by the defense here. A few extra seconds, and those receivers might have been open.
So it's second down and 13 yards to go following that quarterback sack. Defensive coordinator anticipating this five-wide set, and he comes in with his dime package. Caught, and he's hit immediately.
It's a big-time effort sack by the defensive end. I want to also give some credit to the coverage downfield. The end never gave up on the play, but because the quarterback didn't have anywhere to go with the football, it gave the defensive end enough time to eventually chase the quarterback down for that sack.
The sack makes this a fourth and very long. He gets it away. This is a really nice punt. And he's taken down at the 43-yard line. And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. Nice run to the left there. From their own 47-yard line. Second down. Right around the 46-yard line. They get a one-yard loss on that one.
Pretty good stand there. They weren't fooled at all by the offensive play call. That makes it 37.
Third down, and they need to get it inside the 47. He's out of bounds around the 39-yard line. Fielded at the 19. They'll bring him down at the 26. You talk about our meetings this week with the defensive coordinators, Kirk, and this is what they were hoping for, that they can control the line of scrimmage.
These players must have been listening pretty intently, because that's exactly what we've seen. These defenses have come out. They've controlled things early, trying to just set the tone. It's really going to be up to both of these offenses to try to make some adjustments and try to be able to come after them in some way.
Tackled after a decent pickup.
Gain of 6 yards. That'll make it second and four.
So it's second down now. They need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Quick pass. And he's level at the 43.
Boy, when you can rely on your tight end to move the chains, you've got a big-time advantage over any defense.
It to the 44. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 44. And they make the stop at the 41.
Gain of 3 yards. That'll make it second and 7.
We're through one quarter. The Bearcats with a touchdown lead. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter. Incomplete. need to get it down to the 34.
When you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
He doesn't want a touchback here. He wants to knock this ball inside the 10.
Gets it away. Wait a minute. He's going to throw.
Well, they decided to go for it, but the defense slammed the door on him. That's the definition of coming through when it matters most.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
Steps out of bounds.
At about the 37-yard line.
From their own 37-yard line. It's second down. Makes the catch and look out. Tackle made at the 47. He's taken down to the 38-yard line. Second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. He gets hit out of bounds at the 1 yard line.
That makes it first and goal.
The Cougars wide receiver out with an apparent injury, although he might make a comeback later in this game.
If these defenders continue to exploit the O-line like that, it's going to be a long day for this running back.
Second down and goal. Ball on the 3. Tight end, but he bottles the ball away.
I love to see a confident quarterback, but you don't want to just go back there and put blind faith into your throws. You need a little bit more time to evaluate the coverage before you release the football.
They'll bring him down at the 2. A 1 yard gain by the halfback.
They're going to go for the easy 3 here.
He gets it up, and it is good.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes.
Brought down at the 27.
Gain of 1 on the play. That brings up second and 9.
Second down and 9 to go. Ball on the 27. Field.
You know what? After a play like that, I wouldn't be the least bit surprised if they went to the air again.
That'll make it 3rd and 1.
Run to the outside.
Tackle,
their own 39-yard line. First down. He's tackled around the 48-yard line.
That brings up second and one.
He's tackled at the 50-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 50-yard line. And he just gets rid of it.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
They bring the quarterback down. After the sack, it's now fourth and long.
The smart quarterbacks and offensive linemen have a really unique relationship. A quarterback should take care of his offensive lineman. But after that play, and that hit, you really got to be wondering what kind of relationship this quarterback and his offensive lineman have after that.
Tackle made at the 33-yard line. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. He makes it out to maybe the 36-yard line. From their own 36-yard line, it's second down. That'll be a gain of 3 yards.
That's a nice completion, but give the defense a lot of credit. They weren't fooled at all. They were able to hold him to a short game.
It. He's in space. The Bearcats will use their first time out of the half. Doesn't look like he's going to have much time to get rid of this punt. And down he goes at the 23-yard line. The Bearcats offensive staff, I think, has done a good job of keeping their wide receiver in the game, even though he's not having great stats. He's part of it, and the rest of the team now is picking up his slack, I think.
But this offense is still putting points on the board, and I think at times they're actually using the wide receiver, the go-to man who's drawing so much attention, really as a decoy, open up other avenues of this offense. We've seen other receivers make some plays. They're running the football. So it'll be interesting to see what kind of adjustments this defense makes to try to slow down these other members of this offense, and who knows, maybe that could open it back up for that marquee receiver.
They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. And he's taken down at the 41-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
There are 5 wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. Fires quickly, and he's got his man. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. Knocked out of bounds at the 40. He's going to try and scramble, and he's going to be sacked. They've been all over this quarterback today.
The pass protection has got to do a better job, but give this defense some credit. They've really figured out what they have to do to pressure the quarterback and cause him some problems.
He heaves it deep. Incomplete. So at the end of the half, the Bearcats lead 7-3. great first half. Hopefully the second half's as good.
He's out to the 30. Gets out to about the 31.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Quick pass, intercepted. Tackle at about the 31.
It's a great job in coverage by this linebacker. He does a good job of reading the quarterback's eyes and is able to come up with the interception.
From the 31-yard line, it's first down. And he hits him hard at the 15-yard line. Him down in the backfield.
More plays like this, and the coaching staff is going to need to change up the blocking schemes. You can't allow the defense to play in your backfield.
From the 17-yard line, second down. Into the tailback, and he's met in the backfield. Field in the gun with five wide receivers.
And he is drilled at the 27-yard line.
Fourth and long here after the sack. Kick is up, and he splits the uprights. They line up to kick this one away. Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Bearcats continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
And the offense will take the field, and they're certainly hoping to do better than they did on their last drive, which ended with a turnover.
Each possession gets more and more vital as the game goes on, especially when you're behind. You can't afford to make many more mistakes.
And down he goes, around the 30-yard line. From their own 30-yard line, second down.
It's a bad play overall by the offense. The quarterback's doing everything he can to be able to make the play work and try to execute. The problem is the offensive line did not do a good job protecting him. They're very fortunate that ball wasn't intercepted.
He unloads it. Makes the catch, and he might take it down the sideline. What a play, and that'll set up a first and goal. Perfect time for the play-action pass.
Well, here the defense is looking for the run, and the play-action put them in even a worse position. They just weren't ready for the pass there.
Down, and they are very close to tying this thing up. And he tackles him hard at the 4. And he's tackle right away. The offense is down by seven, so this is a very, very big third and goal. We're at the one. And the goal line defense digging in here. Touchdown.
There are some guys, when they get near the goal line, they just have a knack for getting the ball into the end zone. That's what we saw right there.
Boy, we sure have a great game on our hands here. We couldn't have asked for a more evenly matched game up until this point.
And he hits the PAT. A nice six play, 76-yard drive, and they put up 7 points. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Pushed out of bounds at the 26. You don't want to squander any possessions, but maybe now's the right time to dip into your bag of tricks a little. Think about some gadget plays to catch the defense napping. Now he's flushed and they got it. Defense looking for another sack in this second down and long situation. And he throws it away. Can this offense do anything to slow down this defense?
Well, they need to start keeping their backs in to help out in blocking. The quarterback is getting pounded back there.
The sack makes this a fourth and very long. These special teams have done it before, blocking punts. It looks like they're coming after this one. Oh, excellent punt. Nice yardage on the run back.
The quarterback did a really good job in the last drive of finding his receivers in space, and I bet he'll be looking to do the same thing again.
The halfback with a carry. Makes it to the 41. Nice job by the running back, and that'll get him 7, maybe 8 yards. That makes it second. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. They make the stop around the 43-yard line. Loss of 2 yards on the play.
Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun.
Fires it out. Tackle made at the 20.
That makes it first and 10.
First and 10. Ball on the 20. Makes it to the 18-yard line.
Gain of 2 yards. That makes it 7 and 8.
Gets to about the 17-yard line. And so it's another third down upcoming here. Got a man tackled for a loss.
loss of five there.
This defense is fast enough that they can create negative yards on completed passes. So the offense might want to consider that next time they try that play.
So at the end of three, and a 10-10 tie in this game. Just about set to get back to the action here in quarter number four in a tie ball game. Kicks away, and it sails through the uprights.
And with that, all the pressure now shifts back to the other side. That's what a good kicker can do.
Looks like they're ready for the kick. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Here we are early in the fourth quarter in a very, very tight ball game. And every possession is going to count from here on out. He's taken down at the 22-yard line.
You know, these backwards plays can have a psychological impact. It can damage a team's confidence if it keeps happening.
Second and 13 coming up here. Ball on the 22. Incomplete. They got a hand on it. He threw that to a guy who was well covered, and it almost got intercepted.
Yeah, he's very lucky. That ball was only tipped.
They bring him down. I mean, this is almost getting ridiculous. That is sack number eight.
This guy's going to have to spend a half an hour in the ice tub after this game. It's just been shot after shot all day long. Where's the offensive line?
After the sack, it's now fourth and long. He really got a hold of that one. Gets to about the 47-yard line. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game.
Hey, Oklahoma!
Hand off, brought down quickly. From the 47-yard line, second down. He's at the 30, makes it out to about the 26. He's got it with room to run. He gets hit out of bounds, right around the 20.
That brings him second and five.
Second and five. Ball on the 20-yard line. Nice run up the middle. He's tackled around the 14-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 14-yard line. Just under three to go in regulation.
7-yard toss play to the halfback.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to first down.
Feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
And this is the 8th play of the drive. Needed that play, and he dropped it. It's 4th down. This one should be makeable. It's up, and they tack on 3 points. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. He's to the 20. Gets to about the 24-yard line. The Bearcats have sort of set up the defense with this wide receiver doing most of the damage. Do they go away from him or do they do something different?
I think one of two things here for this offense. You either find a way to get your star receiver the football, or in some cases you want to use him as a decoy, maybe take two or three defenders with him, and then open it up for somebody else to be able to make a play.
Quick pass. And he's tackled right around the 32-yard line.
Call it a gain of 8 yards. That makes it 2nd and 2.
Just under 2 minutes in the game. He sails it long. And he snags that one. They'll bring him down right around the 24-yard line.
That's a good move. That makes it 1st and 10.
So let's see how the defense responds now. It's 1st down and 10.
Great play call. And it's very well executed. Any coach would be happy with that kind of outcome on a 1st or 2nd down play.
Brought down at the 1. The Bearcats are going to call their 2nd timeout. So here we go. 1st and goal, and a field goal won't cut it. The extra point that can give them the lead. And he converts the extra point. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Excellent kick. Looking for the corner. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Boy, this has been a fun game to watch, going back and forth and back and forth. It's almost like watching a tennis match here. Whoever has the ball last, my guess, will be the team that wins it.
You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with 5 wideouts. Fires out to his receiver. Tackle at the 36-yard line. Under a minute left. He wants it all. And he hits him hard at the 29-yard line. The defense has got some of their best pass defenders on the field. They set up in the dime to counter that 5 wide receiver set. Caught, and that's a 1st down. And he's taken down right around the 14-yard line. From the 14-yard line, it's 1st down. Got the corner. That tackle just sealed the deal.
Bearcats coaching staff, Kirk, do they start wondering, hey, are we going to have trouble with our star player after the struggles he had today?
Well, I think the coaching staff's got to be happy that this team was able to win the football game and overcome the fact that their star player didn't have a great game. But I think making adjustments and changing the game plan because their star didn't deliver, I think that would be a big mistake.
Well, that wraps things up for us, 3A Sports and Kirk Herbstreit. I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you next time.